project that you can use for your room decor or even as a gift. You can use it in a small picture frame on the table beside your bed, or make it a big project and put it in a huge frame on your wall. Things you will need to make your quilled picture are a picture frame, some colored paper, scissors, two toothpicks, tape, a ruler, a pencil, and some glue. First, take everything out of your picture frame. Next, with your piece of glass from your picture frame, place it on a piece of paper and trace around it and cut it out. Next, place your piece of paper back inside along with everything else, and then trace around the inside of the frame onto the paper from the front and take everything else out again. Next, draw your design you would like your picture to be, making sure it's between all of the four lines you've drawn. Next, with your solid color piece of paper, you're going to be cutting out strips that are about a centimeter wide. Do this for as many as you need. Strips in different sizes and colors. The longer the strip, the bigger the object. The smaller the strip, the smaller the object. With your glue, you can attach a strip of paper along all of the pencil marks you made for your picture, as long as the outside markings. I like to place my glue on a palette and a paintbrush to help me apply my paper. Next, you can place it back into your frame and everything else on top to make sure that it fits, and then take everything out again. Next, we will be wrapping up our papers and putting them inside our picture. You can use a quilling tool or make your own like this. To do this, simply place two toothpicks together and with some tape, wrap it around the entire thing, except leaving the side area open. To use this, place the end of your paper into the slit. Hold it in place and spin the tool to create the effect. Then gently pull away. While holding in place, apply some glue at the end to complete its look. You can also roll up your paper and let it loose before gluing it together to create a larger effect. Doing it this way helps create shapes by pinching the paper. Another way is to roll the paper up halfway and then roll the paper up halfway the opposite way. Once you are done rolling your pieces of paper, you can apply it to the center section on the card with your glue. Once it is dry and complete, you can put it back into your frame and you're done. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to this channel if you enjoyed this video, and give it a big thumbs up, and I'll see you next week. Bye!